It was only you, Father. In the name of Jesus, God, we thank you this morning, Father. Only you got us through last week, God. Only you, Father. Nobody like you. Nobody we can compare to you, Father. Nobody has a name as powerful as yours. It was you, God. Nobody like you, Father. You continue to pour in us, God. You continue to cover us, Father. You continue to keep us, God. There's nobody like you, God. I don't care what they say, Father. I don't care who they serve, Father. There's nobody like you, Father. You are the great I am. You are the King of Kings. You are the Lord of Lords, God. There's nobody like you, Father. Nobody was able to be faithful to us. Nobody was able to cover us. Nobody was able to keep us but you, God. It was only you, Father. Who wouldn't serve a God like you? Who could not serve a God like you? Give him his praise. Give him his due. Who wouldn't serve a God like him? Hey, shut up, see Rosiah. Turn it up, Stefan. Hey, hey. Hey. Survivor. He's a provider. Hey, he's a sustainer. Who wouldn't serve a God like him? Hey. We love you, God. You're so faithful, Father. Hey. Anybody feel kind of confident today? Can you be petty with the devil today? Let him know how God saved you. Let him know how God kept you. Just get a little petty with the devil. Hey. He kept me. Hey. I wanted to quit my job, but my God told me to stand in that thing. Who would serve a God like this? The devil ain't got nothing on Jesus. Come on, somebody. Hey. Who wouldn't serve a God that kept you when you lost your loved one? Who wouldn't serve a God that kept you when no one else would keep you? Who wouldn't serve a God that encouraged you when everybody was trying to pull you down? Who wouldn't serve a God that provided for you like never before? Who wouldn't serve a God that kept your marriage when it was trifling? Who wouldn't serve a God that just encouraged you each and every day? Each and every day. Could you sit on your bottom when you know God done so much for you? Who wouldn't serve a God like that? Who wouldn't serve a God that gave you the approval when you should have got the denial? Who wouldn't serve a God like that? Who wouldn't serve a God when you was living in secret sin and he still kept you and still provided for you? Who wouldn't serve a God like that? Who wouldn't stay too close to a God like that? Something about the Lord. Something about his name. Something about his hand. Something about his connection. Who wouldn't serve a God like that? Father, we thank you this morning. We thank you for blessing us, God. We thank you for keeping us, Lord. We thank you, God, in the name of Jesus. Have your way today, Father. Set the record straight. Let us know, God, it's about you and only you. Let us know, God, that you are the God to serve. Let us know, Father, we thank you, God. So renew and transform our mind. Transform how we think. Transform how we move. Oh, God, renew us today, Father. Oh, God, empty us out, Father, so you can pour in us, Father. Pour the living water, God. God, we thank you today. So, Father, handcuff me in the spirit, Father, so you can do what you need to do, Father. And, God, we thank you, Lord. Who wouldn't serve a God like you? And it's in Jesus' name that we pray this prayer. And all that agree, give God your highest praise. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. It is so. And amen. Who wouldn't serve a God like this? Bless your name, Father. Who wouldn't serve a God like this? He's a keeper, a way maker. He is the one, the great I am. Mm-hmm. Who wouldn't? We're going to be in 2 Kings, the 4th chapter, beginning at verse 38. 2 Kings, the 4th chapter, beginning at verse 38. Mm-hmm. And for those of you who are attending the Truth Matters Bible study, we will be online this Wednesday. I have to travel for work, so we will get you that information shortly after church. It's a login that you can call into it, or you can do the app, and we can see each other and interact that way. So this Wednesday, we will be online. We will not be at the church. And then secondly, for all of you, those who had registered for the conference in April, you have until March the 4th to get your hotel room, and then it goes back up to the full rate, March the 4th. The hotel room is $119. We're only asking you to stay Saturday into Sunday. And so if you got a girlfriend that you can room with, that you don't mind if you ain't high maintenance, y'all can get a double room. But if you like me, you need your own room because you got some issues. But you have until March the 4th to get your room. All right, so we'll be in 2 Kings, the 4th chapter, beginning at verse 38. And the scripture reads as follows. And Elisha returned to Gilgal, and there was a famine in the land. Now the sons of the prophets were sitting before him, and he said to his servant, put on the large pot and boil stew for the sons of the prophets. Verse 39, so one went out into the field to gather herbs and found a wild vine and gathered from it lap full of wild gourds and came and sliced them into the pot of stew. Though they did not know what they were, they served it to the man to eat. Now it happened as they were eating the stew that they cried out and said, man of God, there is death in the pot. And they could not eat it. So he said, then bring some flour. And he put it into the pot and said, serve it to the people so they may eat. And there was nothing harmful in the pot. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. So Elisha is the prophet who had a heart for God, and he was on his assignment. If you know, Elisha was the protege of Elijah. And so when Elijah left, he asked, one request was to get a double portion of the spirit of Elijah. And so if you paid attention in this text, the chapters 1 through 3 give you a number of miracles that took place with Elisha. Elisha was with the Shunammite woman at the time that there was a famine going on in Gilgal. And so God was telling me that the pot was significant to the church. So the title of this message is called Clean the Pot. Clean the Pot. So we are living in a time where we are witnessing the pot, the church, being contaminated with poisonous herbs from the devil's garden. We have allowed the devil to come into the church and call the shots from the pulpit to the back room. And so God is saying that we need to get ourselves to a place of understanding to what is really going on in the church and what is also going on in our own personal lives. You can view the pot as the church, but then you can also take that pot and put it in different areas of your life, or whether it's in your marketplace, whether it's in your home, in your marriage, with your friends. That pot represents what you have placed in it, what you have allowed to go in it, and what you are taking up out of that pot. We have become accustomed to being entertained and fed foolishness to feed our egos and our flesh. We have lost sight of the assignment God has placed on our lives, which is to turn from the things of this world, but use the time to go out and save souls for Christ. God says that he has called us to be Christ carriers for him, which means that we are examples of who he is. And so God is saying, how have we allowed this pot to get so contaminated and we still sit in the pot as if nothing has happened? We have not even asked the leader to go put some flour, to put some salt in the pot to help us out. And as I was doing research on the herbs that were taken from the field at that time, what they did was they picked up these herbs and they picked up these vegetables that looked looked like cucumbers and what's called squash. And they cut it up and it looked as if it was what it was, cucumbers and squash, but it was something that was poisonous. And they said that when they ate it, that the herb that they ate, it messed up their digestive tract. And so God is saying that we begin to allow ourselves to eat out of the pot, and we've allowed it to contaminate every area of our life. That thing hit me really strong this past weekend. He gave me the scripture on Thursday, and I kept reading through it saying, Lord, what are you saying? He said, look a little bit deeper, daughter. He said, you all have become contaminated with what the things of this world is and not the things of the spirit. You have allowed yourself to get comfortable with everything. You have allowed yourself to be entertained. Even as leaders, you have allowed yourself to bump your egos up, to think that it's about you and it's about me. He even got in my backyard. He said, did you read the website lately? You said that you have three vision points and one is physical health. You ain't been working out like I told you to. How can you represent the church and you're not doing what your vision of the church on your website is? And then he went a little bit deeper. He said, ask your congregation, have they went to the website to understand what this church stands for? We don't know if we represent snakes or if we represent Christ. And God says, we got to open our eyes up to what's really going on in this day. We've allowed ourselves to sit in this thing. And God is saying he's calling the prophets through the season to get the famine out of the way. We have been famine in our faith like never before, that the enemy comes and he shakes our faith down. The enemy comes and lies to us, and we begin to believe those things and press into that thing, and we allow it to contaminate our mind. Things that we think we see, we don't see. God then began to tell me about the things of the world. He said, you all are living in a famine of the world. Just because it may look good, just because it looks like a cucumber, don't mean that it's good for you. So I'm here to tell you today that God is saying to clean your pot.
That's right. All right. All right. Help us, Lord. Mm-hmm.
So God reminded me, as Elisha the prophet, he had a heart for the people. He returned to Gilgal to teach the people, to teach the prophets the word of God. So they were able to identify what was true doctrine. That sounds cute till you got to walk that thing out. You know what I'm saying? Sound doctrine. Sound doctrine got to be in your own backyard. God is saying, what are the fruits in your own backyard? Are you living the word of God? Are you believing the word of God? Are you living in your lie? And God is saying, this is a season for you to clean your pot. He went back to the town where there was a famine, and he was at a place before he had left with a woman where he had shelter and he had food. And so God said that I needed my prophet to go without so he can go bring my people back into my will. God is saying he's calling us to a season to go without some things, amen, so we can get the understanding of what the purpose and the destiny for our life is. He said the prophet went back and there was no food, and the prophet understood that the people will be focused on their stomach when they should be focused in the spirit of what God is saying. And God is saying, what have you focused on lately? What has been the distraction of your mind lately? What have you allowed yourself to be contaminated with lately instead of believing what he's saying to you in this season? What have you believed lately? Then he reminded me of 2 Chronicles 7:14. If my people, which means we have a choice, who are called by that my name, will humble themselves. God says we have to learn how to humble ourselves in this season. There's things that he's going to do with us, in us, and for us, but we got to be humbled in that thing. God says this is not a season for you to be distracted with the enemy. He told me the other day, he said, the devil's getting so good in discipline of distracting you that he's trying to take you off your destiny. So God says, humble yourself in this season. Turn from your wicked ways. Turn from the contamination of this world, and he will begin to heal the land. But it starts by the choice. If my people who are called by my name. So the first thing is, are you called by his name? Do you know if he's calling you? Do you know if he's knocking on your door? Do you know if he's waking you up in the midnight hour? Are you being called by his name? That even goes to Denim and Trayvon. You are being called by his name. You don't get a pass just because you're 13 and 14. God says all of us have an assignment that is on our life, and no longer can we begin to continue to eat the poisonous things that feed our flesh. You wonder why you're wavering in your faith, because you got to build your spirit man up. And God says this is a season for you to put some salt in that pot to begin to kill all of the things out of the pot that does not belong. So it starts with faith. The enemy has allowed these situations and circumstances to taint and waver our faith. I'm here to tell you today that your faith is deep-rooted, is the deep-rooted core connection of your communication with God. You got to have some kind of faith to get through this thing called life. You may not have the strong faith. Your faith may be a little wavering, but you got to start somewhere. And God says if you got a little bit of faith, the size of a mustard seed, you're giving them something to work with. But if you have no faith, then he has nothing to work with. There's no core. There's no foundation. There's no ride in your back. But you got to have some kind of faith. Well, Pastor, how do I know if I have some faith? Well, then you got to begin to go into your faith files and see if you got anything in there. Have you ever been in a season without? Have you ever been in a season where you needed to be covered? Have you ever been in a season where you needed God to encourage you? Have you ever been in a season where you wanted to give up? Have you ever been in a season when you felt like you was by yourself? And then there was something about the goodness of the Lord that gave you a little bit more push to press on through. So I'm here to tell you today, do you have a little bit of faith? Are you giving God something to work with today? You got to have a little bit of faith. I was watching something on Instagram with Reverend Al Sharpton. He was at Jamal Bryant's church, and he was talking about his mother, and he told his mother that his friends were coming to church with him. And he said, "Mother, now when we get to church, can you please not embarrass me?" And she said, "What do you mean, son?" He said, "Mother, when you get to church and when they start to praise and worship the Lord, can you not start leaning to the side and start rocking and rocking and rocking and shouting before the Lord?" And she said, "Boy, I ain't paying you no attention." So he then went to church, and he said that his mother, she began to stand up, and he knew what she was going to do. She began to lean to the side and rock back and forth, and she began to shout and jump up and down saying hallelujah. He said he was so embarrassed by his friends and by his mother that he just put his head down. And then he said there was a time that he was doing a march for a young man who had lost his life, and someone came up and stabbed him in the chest, and he went to the hospital, and he said the doctors were saying that they didn't know if he was going to live. And he said he then told the doctors and the nurse that he needed to call his mother because he knew his mother knew how to pray like never before. So his mother said a prayer for him, and the doctor came in the next day, and the doctor then began to say, "My son, I don't know what's going on, and I don't know what happened yesterday, but when I looked at your test results today, things are looking a little bit differently." And then he said he began to get up on the edge of the bed, and he began to get himself up, and the nurse said, "You can't get up right now." And he said that, "Oh no, ma'am, you don't understand." And then the doctor said that IV is in his arm. And then he said he got up in your way before she can get over there. And he began to lean over a little bit and shake a little bit and shake a little bit. And he began to jump up and down. And he said at that moment, he understood the faith of his mother. So I'm here to ask you today, do you have a little bit of faith inside of you? Is there something for the Lord to work with? Do you got something inside of you? You just need the size of a mustard seed. He ain't asking you for a whole lot, but you got to give God a little bit of something to work with. Thank you. For those of you who are taking notes, faith is deep-rooted. It's the communication. It's your lifeline to the Lord. And God says if you trust him in this particular season, he's going to show you some things like never before. If you trust him in this season, you will begin to be able to lean over and rock back and forth. And when you get into the church house, you'll be able to jump before the Lord. And people may not understand what happened to you, but there's something about when you just have a little bit of faith. You just got to have a little bit. You just got to have a little bit. Just a little bit of faith. And God is saying, is your faith, have your faith been contaminated lately? What have you allowed yourself to be focused on? You thought it was a cucumber and it was a dagger from the devil. And God is saying, and he's telling you today, that you got to begin to clean your eye gates up, baby. You got to know the difference from a cubic zirconia and a diamond. And God is saying, if you trust him in the season, he will show you how to water the plants. He will show you how to put some salt in in that stew and make it taste a little bit better. So cleaning the pot starts with your faith. And then God says, then it moves over to your mind. When your mind has been transformed and renewed, you look at that thing differently. You look at that thing like the doctor did. I don't know what happened. I don't care what they saying, but I know the God that I serve. There's something that's going on in my ear where he's telling me I can and I will and I must. There's something that's going on in my body that's saying to keep on pushing like never before. There's something that's going on in my circumstance that I'm not upset anymore in the marketplace. I'm not upset in my marriage anymore, that I have a joy and a leap for the Lord, that I trust him because I gave him a little bit of faith and something to work with. God says your mind begins to be renewed and transformed when you give him something to work with. You are poisoning your mind with lies of the enemy because you're not giving God the time and the space to lay residency up here. Because if it's up here, then it goes here and then it comes out in your actions. And so God is saying, what have you allowed your mind to be focused on lately? Is it about you and what you want in your flesh? Or is it about him and his will and the destiny for your life? God says, no longer can you walk around the things of 2019. Keep talking about you hurt, do this and you that. God says, this is a season that you come before him and say, Father, my pot is dirty. God, I have allowed things in my pot. I've allowed people in my life. I've allowed situations in my mind. I fed my flesh, God, and I'm overweight in my flesh. Oh, God, I need to go on a diet in my flesh, Father. Oh, God, I need to build my faith like never before. God is saying, come to him today and be transparent. Tell him what you need to work on. Tell him what's been contaminating you in your body and in your mind so he can begin to clean that thing out. There's a famine that's going on in your life. You wandering around, you still wrestling with that thing. Because there's a famine that's going on in your life. That you've not put on that full armor that we talked about last week. You've not got into your prayer closet. Some things can't be happening out in the opening. Some things you got to be in a close space with the Lord. You just got to get in that close place with the Lord. And you got to begin to kneel down to God and say, Father, it's me and it's you. Oh, God, I need you like never before. God says you got to get into a close place with him. Have you allowed yourself to get in that space with God so he can begin to deal with you? The church is contaminated. Our minds have been contaminated because we continue to allow things in the pot that don't belong. We continue to allow people in the pot that don't belong. We continue to allow the internet in the pot. And it don't belong. The internet is for social media. That's it, just to be social. The internet is not for you to explode your life out on the internet. This is not cuffing season. You know how they say cuffing season, Elder Jay? Let me help you out a little bit. That means when you need to get booed up. And God says in this season, you need to cuff the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit gonna help you with something. The Holy Spirit is gonna tell you about something. This is not the season for you to cuff the things of this world. This is a season for you to cuff the Lord. Have him at your hip. Have him in your mind. Have him on your lips. Have him in your actions. Have him with the integrity of your life. This is the season for you to clean your pot and stop playing around with the devil.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
He says, then we go to the body. How are we keeping our body? Are we allowing our bodies to allow the Lord to lay residency in our body? Do we have good hospitality with our body? I was listening to the Christian radio station on Sirius XM, and it was this doctor who's in ministry, and he was talking about the body and high blood pressure and diabetes and those things. And he said, the thing about Christians is that we don't know how to be disciplined with our body. He said, we'd like to ask God for healing, but we the one that's contaminated ourselves. We've asked God to heal our high blood pressure, but we steady eating the things that triggers it. We ask God to get our blood sugars elevated, but we continue to eat things because we lack discipline with the mouth. So that thing hit me deep. And that's when the Lord took me to the website. He said, you don't got so contaminated with distractions that you forgot what the vision of this church is. Part of it is the body. And I need the people who are called by my name that's attached to this house, that they will be able to see your fruits of your spirit. You can't put on that website that you believe in physical well-being if you're not being physically well-being yourself. Amen. God says this is a season to see true sound doctrine. Well, Pastor, let me go to the website real quick and see what you're really talking about. Let me see if I see you walk that thing out for real. You can't be on Facebook on Monday talking about this and that, and on Sunday you're going to tell me, thus says the Lord. God says this in a season. You got to check it. Trust but verify. Is she really living by the vision? Do I understand the visions of this house? Who am I connected to? Do I see it in her family? Do I see it in our conversations? Who am I connected to in this season? The body. God said he's reminding us what we eat will determine how we move. You know how you feel bloated sometimes? That medium is kind of like, ooh, Lord, just a little bit tight. That medium will get you real good. I tried on a pair of pants. They said, I knocked the day, pumpkin. And God was saying, because when you feel here, you can't hear me here. So you got to begin to tell your body that I got to put you on a little bit diet. Because, see, I trusted you last year, and some things didn't work out for me. So I'm going to have to turn over this plate this year and see what's a little bit different for me. So I said to myself that I was fasting from drinks. You know, I like me some ginger ale. I ain't supposed to have it. It breaks my face. And I'd be like, Lord, clear my face. He said, stop drinking the ginger ale. That's that simple. And so God is saying, what do you need to fast from to clean your pot? You have to really ask yourself, how am I living in this season? You have to really ask yourself, who am I connected to in this season? Don't just believe it because it sounds good. Know the church that you're connected to, what we believe in, what we're doing in the community. Amen. God says this is a season of for real. Amen. Amen. The truth. Yes. And nothing but the truth. I don't need half truth. I don't need a little bit of truth. I need the whole truth and nothing but the truth. I can't sit in a contaminated pot. It almost took me out 2 years ago. Amen. I need to sit in something that's a little bit clean. Have y'all been cleaning up around here lately? Amen. Amen. So then the Lord said about the soul, what are you feeding your soul with? What have you connected? Who have you connected yourself to? You know, people talk a lot about soul ties, and that is so true. I seen a little sign that said that people know you by the energy before they speak to you. And so you got to begin to examine the energy that you around. Something ain't about this don't sound right, don't feel good, so I'm going to have to keep pushing, but I pray for you, though. Right. And so you got to begin to have real conversations with yourself.
Yes.
Father, is this real? Does this make sense? Because there's such a famine in society today. Church is closing. People just want to be entertained. And God said to me, daughter, the word should cut you first. And then you have to deliver it to the people. Because their lives are worth too much to me.
That's right.
For you to play around with what they got going on. Yeah. Their lives are worth too much to me for you not to break this thing and make it plain and clear to them. Their lives is worth too much to me for you not to live it and walk it yourself. Their lives is worth too much to me for you to play around in my pulpit. So God is saying that he's calling us today to stand up and take an oath with him. Father, today I want to clean my pot. If you believe, you need to clean your pot. Take an oath with God today and stand up and say, Father, today I want to clean my pot. Father, today I need to clean my pot. God, we want to clean our pots today, Father. We want to clean our pots like never before. God, we want to clean our pots. We want to clean our pots in our faith. We want to clean our pots in our faith. We want to clean our pots in our faith, God. We want to clean our pots in our faith. Father, you had said that all we need is just the size of a mustard seed. So, Father, I decree and declare that today, Father, that you activate the mustard seed in each one of us today. I decree and declare today, Father, the enemy can have no dominion over our faith. I decree and declare today, God, that you recall every miracle that you have done in the Bible and in our life. I decree and declare today that, God, we will trust you with our faith. I decree and declare today, Father, that we will feed our faith, God. We will believe what you told us last year and the year before. God, we will feed our faith with what you've already done, God. We will feed our faith, Father, And we will remove anything that does not belong. Turn it up, Stephanie. Father, we would also, Father, to turn it down just a little bit. I'm sorry. I thought it was a different song. We will feed our faith, Father, and transforming and renewing our mind. God, we want a renewed mind, Father. We don't want to think out of the flesh, God, but we want to think in the spirit. Father, some have been distracted, Father, in their mind, God. They are battling things of the enemy, Father. And today, Father, I decree and declare, Father, that you will bust through the enemy's plans, Father. I decree and declare today, God, that they will trust you in their mind. I decree and declare, Father, that they will lay hands on their mind and say, I am renewed in my mind. I will only think of the things of the Lord. God, I thank you. And Father, we decree and declare, God, that we will renew our bodies, Father. We will allow lack of discipline, Father, to impact our bodies, God. And Father, we decree and declare today, Father, you will give us a plan, Father, how to live a healthy life, God. Oh, God, in the name of Jesus, show us, Father, how to work with what we have, Father. Some cannot afford memberships, but God, show them how to lift the leg at home, God. Show them, Father, how to make right decisions with eating, God. Father, show us, Father. How to put the body, Father, on a diet, Father, so we can have well-being in our mind, Father, well-being in our hearts, God. Oh, God, we need you today, Father. And, Father, we ask that you lift our soul up like never before. That, Father, we trust you today, Father. God, we thank you, Father. Some need to be poured into in their soul, God. And Father, I thank you for the pouring, Father. I thank you, dear God, that you show them, Father, how to clean their pot. We thank you, Father. We need a cleaning, God. We don't want to take you for granted. We just don't want to say we came to church, God. We want a word from you, Father. In Jesus' name. Step on, play some soft music. Bless your name. Yes. Yes, God. Father, have your way. That's who you are, God.
You are.
Bless your name. Trust God in the season for your life. Begin to journal down some of the things that he's telling you. Because he's going to show you something different. I'm a firm believer and a faith walker that God is turning the pot upside down. And he's setting the record straight. God said he's placed something inside of you where you can change an atmosphere. The devil may be knocking on your door and you open it with your petty spirit and let him know. How can I help you today, sir? You give him a scripture. God says this is your season for you to go in your marketplace and change the environment with your presence. The prophet put the flour in the pot to kill the diseases. God says he's put word inside of you to kill the lies of the enemy. God says he's put word inside of you to lay hands on yourself. God said he has put word inside of you for you to lay hand on your family members. God says he has put word inside of you for you to press this thing out. If you need to be healed, then you decree and declare healing over your body and ask God for discipline for you to do your part so he can do his part. You may be seated. But this is a season for you to trust God. If you haven't been to the Chosen's website, get on there and see what we stand for as a church. You should never be connected to something that you don't know the true vision. I may support Trump. That's a lie. You need to know who you connected to in this season. You got to ask some questions and begin to let God minister to you like never before. Clean your pot. Clean your pot. You may have to clean your friends list. You may have to clean the books you're reading. You may have to clean what you're putting in your eyesight. Clean your mouth. Life and death is in the power of the tongue. Stop saying something almost killed you. It didn't. Stop saying, if it ain't one thing, it's another. You declare the atmosphere when you wake up every morning. God, I thank you for waking me up. Father, I thank you that today is going to be a blessed day. God, I thank you that you give me an opportunity to kill the devil in any pathway that I'm walking in. This is your season to clean your pot. Amen. We don't do the doors of the churches open because the church is always open. But if you need to give your life to Christ, you need to rededicate your life to Christ. And don't care who's sitting next to you, it's about you. You can come on down and have a seat. We're not going to ask you to say anything. Elder Jamie will get with you. If you need prayer, Minister Braxton will get with you. If you need to just meditate, go ahead. But this is a season for us to clean our pots. Our life is worth way too much for us to be living a lie. It's easy to say that the church is contaminated, but not to look in our own backyard. Because we are a part of the church. So we got to begin to see the things that we've allowed in our pots. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Stephanie, you can tell me.
Said, if you want to be prayed for or just bask in his glory, you could do that as well. But I also want to let you know that we have some fresh fruit over in the hospitality room and some muffins over there if you would like to help yourself to that also.
We cry out all waymaker, Shiva. Shiva, Shiva, we lift our hands and worship away.
it all.